this is essentially here most of the manuscripts of everything that I've written since I was 15 years old. Do you want the musical version or the standard version? This is the first novel, or I guess you'd say novella, that I ever wrote. It's called The Journey. And it was about a blind old man that gets led into the mountains to die by his grandson, who's a Chicano kid. He's half Native American and half Chicano. And his grandfather is an Indian who can't get to the happy hunting ground if he's blind. So the kid leads him up into the mountains to die. And I wrote this after a summer I spent out west in 1957, when I got a job working for room and board at the Southwest Research Station in Portal, Arizona, and wound up fighting forest fires in the Chiricahua Mountains of southeastern Arizona, and working for scientists, gathering bugs, catching rattlesnakes, finding gloriosa beetles, collecting grasshoppers down near Rodeo, New Mexico, and looking for mites behind their gills. And a lot, this is, when I was in college, I wrote one or two novels a year, not for any classes because they didn't have creative writing classes at that time. But I have all the manuscripts. This one, Red Savage, is a hockey novel. I loved playing hockey. And there's another one. Where is it? I don't see it. I wrote another book called Don't Be Forlorn, based on the Emmett Till case. Emmett Till was a African-American kid from, I think, Chicago that got lynched in either Mississippi or Alabama. And many of these manuscripts are books that never got published. I would guess that I only publish about one out of every four books that I write. These are manuscripts for The Sterile Cuckoo, the first book that I did manage to publish. And as you can see, it was rewritten time and 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 time again. I'm not a natural writer. I can't think things out beforehand. So I just rewrite, 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 rewrite. And sometimes things work out. This is The Wind Heart, a book that I wrote when I was 23. It never got published. Here's different drafts of it. Medal of Honor was one of the first anti-war books I wrote in the 60s, 1967, 68. It never got published. Mary Jo is a little novel about a topless dancer in New York City. That never got published. Hey and Boo and Bang is another novel that I wrote when I first moved to New York City in 1963. It never got published. Number 25 is a novel that, God, I worked on for 20 years, different drafts, and never managed to work it out, get it published. See, all these are number 25, number 25, all these are. All these are Sterile Cuckoo drafts. Wizard of Loneliness was the second novel I published, probably about the 10th book that I'd written. And here's drafts for that. All of these are wizard drafts. Originally, it was The Wizard of Loneliness, a clean first draft. It was written in the first person by a guy who was 40 years old, looking back on his childhood during World War II. And I wrote it in the first person for I don't know how many drafts, and then finally switched to the third person. When I switched to the third person, it started working out better. Here's one. This one was called The Silver Apples of the Moon. But see, they were all written, again, just sort of printed out. This is the way I wrote novels. And before I switched to the typewriter, and I used to use da-da-da-da-da-da, charge, I used, all these little Hermes rockets. This is the original throwaway typewriter. I love these little guys. And I started writing on Hermes rockets in 1956. And I finally typed on them so much you could actually, they cost about $40. And you could, you could write a book, bang the shit out of the typewriter, throw it away when you were done, by another Hermes rocket for $40, write another book on it. This book was the one that I wrote the Milagro Beanfield War on. And then I bought an Olympia Portable. And the Olympia Portable was such a much better typewriter that it lasted for years and years and years.